He's one of the power brokers to watch in 2011, and he's the chairman of the Federal Trade Commission. John Liebowitz joining me here. Thank you so much for the time. Appreciate it.
Good to be here, Peter.
Let me ask you, first of all, about 2011 going forward. First of all, congratulations on your recognition in Business Week. And what is your sense of the level, the state of competition right now in America, and what are your top concerns and priorities heading into 2011?
So the state of competition in America, we think, is pretty good. We've just released today new numbers on Hart-Scott-Rodino merger filings, and they've gone up by 63% in the last year from 2009 to 2010.
And explain to our viewers what that means for you. That's the number of transactions you've actually reviewed.
That we've reviewed, or the Justice Department has reviewed. Because we're antitrust regulators and we have to review these deals to make sure they're not anti-competitive. So we're still in a recession. We haven't pulled out yet, but what it suggests is that money is beginning to go back into merger activity, and that's probably a good thing.
So your business, so your office is about to get busier?
Our office has already gotten busier, and we suspect the 2011 numbers, when they come out, which will be in probably another 11 or 12 months, will be even higher because we've been very, very busy on merger activity. Of course, we're a consumer protection and a competition agency, and so on the competition side, we try to make sure that the marketplace is fair and that companies don't act anti-competitively. And on the consumer protection side, we're very, very involved in privacy issues. We released a very, very meaningful report where we called for more transparency and more choice for consumers and a do not track option. So
Let me follow up on that, because that has gotten a lot of attention, a lot of interest. This is the notion that Americans who surf the web all the time, they are being tracked to some extent by some of those advertisers out there, some mm-hmm. of those companies operating in the internet. What is your concern here, and what is your solution?
So our concern is this, that consumers ought to have a choice about whether they're being tracked by cookies all around the internet. Now, these cookies are put in to consumers' computers by companies when you click on their advertisements, or you click on their website. And most consumers wouldn't mind having targeted advertising. I certainly like having it. It relates to my preferences. But having said that, consumers ought to have choice, and that's something we believe in, and we've been very heartened by the support we've gotten from industry so far. A way to do a do not track mechanism would be through an internet browser, and Microsoft and Mozilla, the two largest companies, one a for-profit, one a non-profit, but the two largest browser companies in terms of market share have both said they're going to implement that. We think that's good for consumers.
Are you satisfied with the industry response to date?
We are satisfied with some segments of the industry response to date. We're still working with advertisers and marketers to move this initiative forward, but it's certainly gotten a lot of resonance and traction, and that's good.
To what extent is the FTC now concerned about the online space as perhaps a primary area of concern for you? So much talk about the social networks, about online search right now. Is this going to be a focal point for you? And what are your concerns, for example, about the Facebook and those social marketers?
Well, I think it's an area we continue to monitor and we continue to care about. We obviously believe in things like transparency of privacy policies and choice for consumers. And there are issues in the social networking area and in the other that relate to that and relate critically to that. We also spend a lot of time going after scammers and folks who just rip off consumers and use the internet to advertise, and that ranges from debt consolidators who say, don't worry, pay me $5,000 up front and I'll take care of your credit card problem, and they take the money and they run. To a variety of other malefactors who use the internet. We're sort of paid as an agency to worry about that, and we try to do our best, and we bring cases against the worst abusers.
Let me ask you about one final area of concern that for you, and that is the drug industry. Mm-hmm. You've taken on this notion of pay to delay. Drug companies essentially paying generic drug makers to delay mm-hmm. generic rivals coming to market. Where does this stand right now? You've been pushing to try and get legislation in Congress. You're not there yet.
We're not there yet, but we're going to keep on pushing. We have sort of a two-pronged strategy to stop what we believe is an unconscionable practice, and it's the practice of a brand company. And by the way, most brand companies don't do it, just a few, paying off a generic and most generic companies don't do it, to stay out of the marketplace. That means consumers, whether they have insurance or not, are paying much higher prices for pharmaceuticals, because generics are about 10% of the price of brands. And we're going to pursue both a litigation strategy, try to get a case to the Supreme Court, and a legislative strategy, support the many bipartisan members of Congress, Chuck Grassley, Susan Collins, Herb Kohl, Senator Schumer and Durbin, we endorse their legislation, and we hope they can get it enacted. Henry Waxman on the House side is our lead sponsor.
Mr. Chairman, thanks for the time. Appreciate you joining us.
Thank you so much, Peter, for having me.